All right, Annetta, lock the doors, because what I'm about to say is going to upset some people right next here. Okay. Christopher Columbus did not discover America.
People of African descent go back hundreds of years in Mexico, but as a group, Afro-Mexicans are largely invisible.
Ay, tú eres cubana, ¿no? Porque también ahí dices, otra madre, el clásico colombiano, venezolana, de algún otro lado menos mexicano.
In his diary of his second voyage, Columbus tells of how the natives of Hispaniola actually had given him gold-tipped metal spearheads that they said were brought by black-skinned people who had come in large boats from the south and southeast. These spearheads were covered in this metal that, this alloy that the inhabitants called guanin, which, dun-dun-dun, matched the metal used in spearheads made in Western Africa for thousands of years as carried by medieval African warriors, including the Mali and the Moors. The West Africans even called this metal guanine, the same name used by the natives of Hispaniola. But nothing more was said about that. These murals are from the Temple of the Warriors at Chichen Itza. Now they clearly feature, the color version is easier to see, but they clearly feature three races. And there are, it's depicting black and Indian allies and a battle against white invaders. And because this mural shows that blacks are clearly fighting on the side of the Mayans, that they must have been integrated into that society much longer before this painting was done. There are numerous pre-Columbian figurines with striking similarities to ancient African artwork, and they've been found in Central and South America. In southeastern Mexico, there are 18 rock statues that of heads up to 11 feet tall that are facing the ocean. These people that they modeled them after must have been important. Whoever they were, they must have been important to be remembered or obeyed or worshiped. Well, Jose Meglera Serrano, the archaeologist who first uncovered them, he pointed out that facial features look amazingly like African blacks, and they all display distinctive headgear or protective helmets.
Son personas afrodescendientes de todas partes, que tienen hijos y que van dejando generaciones en esta diversidad de lo que es la afrodiáspora.
Dan Hoy says before slavery ended in America, slaves would flee to Mexico by following trails left in the sand by Mexican wagoneers who traded goods.
Why would slaves cross the border to seek asylum in Mexico? And the answer is clear. This is Vicente Guerrero, a Mexican man who was born from humble beginnings. Born in Mexico, his mother was an indigenous woman, and his father was an Afro-Mexican. That's right, an African born in Mexico. Vicente was born at the lowest level of the Spaniard caste system, a system designed to hinder Afro and indigenous from seeing the highest level of social status in Mexico. However, through hard work and fighting for his country, Vicente was able to transcend the caste system. He was no longer considered a color. He became a legend, the people's hero. The people loved him so much, they made him the second president of Mexico. That's right, an Afro descendant. While in office, he took steps to give the indigenous people rights and abolish slavery, the very system that he grew up under. This is why slaves flee to Mexico, so they could be free. Vicente Guerrero is a true definition of a Mexican and also represents a group that I'm looking for, the Afro-Mexican community. Tell me, when you think about Mexican history, do you think about the African contribution? The truth is, at one point, there were more Africans being born in Mexico than there were indigenous and Spanish, but those numbers have dwindled through generational mixed unions and migration. Because of this, many Mexicans are not aware of their African heritage. In this documentary, I want to learn more about Mexico's African history and hopefully find an Afro-Mexican descendant community.
Okay, so we're at the Museum of Anthropology, Jalapa, and this is the area where we're gonna see the Olmec heads. A lot of you guys have been, 24 hours ago, he Bogota. Yeah, this guy likes to travel, so make sure you check out. But yeah, we're here to find out the culture about the indigenous Olmec people. And this scene, some
Olmec heads here, but we have to check in here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. So I wanted a guide here, but you gotta request that super early. So if you wanna come here, come see these beautiful indigenous heads right here, okay? So we'll start off with this one right here. What caught my eye when I first saw it was the nose. It's just this facial feature. It reminded me of just African features. And so I wanted to see it for myself. And just not only that, to see how huge it is. All right, so as you can see, this thing is truly colossal. And so what we'll do is we'll just scan.
Ultra Lacritus is the eight colossal head. It is considered as one of the most preserved colossal heads. The Helfman has a band where four elements can be appreciated. They have been interpreted as filling plows and raptor nails. This colossal head is the only one with a semi-roundy shape, so it was possible that it was carved in one size, unlike the others that were sculpted or recycled.
And so we'll go. This is something I probably would have seen in Africa though.
And there it is, guys. This is the one that caught my eye. Oh my gosh, look how beautiful this one is. Oh, look at it. It is amazing, guys. And all this beauty.
Significant and impressive of the colossal heads. This is the first one discovered in San Lorenzo Tenochtitlan, Veracruz, in 1946, during the expedition of Matthew Stirling in the forest lands of the lower basin of the Coatzacoalcos River. This sculpture was found on this slope of ravines facing the sky, and although its conservation state is good, it suffers a fracture on the face near the right eye, which had to be restored. This character has been called the King because of its
get away with our best
majestic appearance. It is one of the largest Olmec monuments, and its archaeological value is as great as its aesthetic value.
You can see where they actually had to fix the eye up, but I think they did a decent job. Yo! Oh, another one I came from.
17 colossal heads in the sites of La Venta, Tabasco, Tres Zapotes, and San Lorenzo. In the last one, 10 works of this type were recovered. The Anthropology Museum of Jalapa safeguards 7 of them, which it is the most complete corpus of this type of monuments. The sites where most of the colossal heads have been found lack of stony fields. Although all the colossal heads have features in common, such as the eyes, frowning, wide nose, and mouth, each one of them has characteristics that makes them different from one to another, such as cheekbones, the smile, and especially every headdress or helmet contains unique designs. The 10 colossal heads were found in different years from 1946 to 1994, but almost all were in context of.
So this is the original piece, but this reminds me of Egypt. I've never been to Egypt, but this piece right here reminds me of Egypt, of what I've seen as far as hieroglyphics are concerned. Just check a look to see. All right, this is what you get right here. All right. This, look at this. I could think that's the pharaoh right there or something. Wow.
Wow, look at these guys are like sounding horns. It's a story that's being told here, guys. Very interesting.
Each color is a little bit different. Look at this one right here. This is a guy that's deliberately painted different from this guy right here. It's no coincidence. They had the color, they could have used it on this guy right here, but he was black. I don't know if the skin represents something, but for me, I think it's.
Hola, ¿y tú? ¿Cómo estás, boy? Yo vengo aquí para hacer una video especial. Yo estoy buscando afrodescendientes mexicanos. Oh my god. Esa es tu empresa. Tú.
Hey.
Es restaurante. ¿Cómo se llama ese restaurante? What's the name of this restaurant?
Omar.
¿Tu nombre?
Licha.
Alicia. ¿Y cuánto tiempo tú tienes esa empresa?
Ya hace muchos años.
Muchos años, como
ya
la.
Vieja aquí.
No, amor, como la 30. ¿Eh?
No, 60.
No, 60. No, amor.
Los negros aguantamos mucho.
¿Tú vives aquí todo tu tiempo, tu vida?
Sí.
¿Tu familia en esa tierra por cuántos años? ¿100 años?
Los abuelos, los papás, los tatarabuelos.
So, like, really, all her family, this is her island right here. ¿Y qué tienen aquí? ¿Qué está haciendo?
Estoy arreglando pescado. Guachinango. Salero, hicimos una película que se llama La Negrada.
Tú no eres mexicana, ¿verdad? ¿De dónde vienes, negra?
Hasta que trabajas, negro. ¿Y esto?
No es para ti.
¿Y entonces?
Entonces nada. No es para ti, se acabó.
Por negra me desprecias, no desprecies mi color, que entre perlas y diamantes, tan negra es la mejor. Ay, ay, ay.
Oh, tú eres la estrella.
¿Dónde vienes tú?
Miami, Florida.
Ah.
Sí, por eso.
Sí, aquí estamos los negritos perdidos, olvidados.
No, ahora. Nos no, dicen, ¿cómo no está perdido?
Sí, pero dicen que no saben que existimos nosotros aquí los negritos.
Sí, hay muchos no saben, por eso.
Okay. My name is Benny.
¿Bernie?
You?
My name is Leah. Oh, you speak English.
Okay. No mucho.
No mucho, ok.
Poquito.
How you learn English? ¿Aquí mucha gente?
Sí.
¿Por cuántos años vive aquí?
Yo, 60 años.
Aquí, en esa tierra.
Sí, yo nací aquí, quitar el monte.
Quitar, vive aquí, es muy bueno.
Sí. Muy bueno. Comer, tomar agua.
¿Toma agua?
No tomar cerveza.
Oh, ¿tú?
No licores.
Ah, para eso está flaco y sí, muy fuerte. Sí.
¿Cuántos años tu familia vivía aquí en esa tierra? ¿Como 200 años?
No, no, como 80 años.
80 años. ¿Antes de acá, aquí, dónde?
Mi abuela, Collantes. Mi papá, Collantes. Uh-huh. Mi abuelo también. Todos Collantes. Pero ellos, cuando mi padre es pequeño, se viene a vivir aquí. Y aquí él crece. Aquí se hace de novio con mi madre. Uh-huh. Y ya vine para Chacagua yo.
¿Tu madre afro también?
Sí, mexicana.
Oh, mexicana, sí. Okay.
Okay. Todos mexicanos. No hay gringos.
No gringo.
No me gusta gringos.
Ay, yo soy gringo, no sé.
No, no soy gringo. No me gustan gringos negros.
Yo soy gringo negro.
Brian Brown Johnson.
Brian Brown Johnson. It was nice. Right, yeah, that's it.
Mi familia está en West Virginia.
Oh, you're fam.
Mucha gente de raza negra, pero ya se está perdiendo un poco el.
¿Cuántos negros aquí? Tú, how many brothers are and sisters here?
El original aquí negro soy solo yo.
Okay.
Only me. La mayor parte de la personas acá vienen de la raza negra.
So most of the people here in this area have probably came from the black race, probably a mixture of Indian, indigenous, and Spanish people, but a lot of them are not familiar with their background. But he's black, though. I just saw that. Yeah, you black.
De hecho, en mis libros, con mi sabiduría, la primera humanidad que hubo aquí en la tierra que existió, todo el ser humano viene de la raza negra. Todos. Y en el transcurso del tiempo, toda la humanidad va a volver a ser negros. Se llama Mente Abierta, buscando mi propio yo, el realismo de la vida. Descúbrete, encuéntrate tú mismo.
You were born here?
Yo me vine acá con mi tía.
Yeah. Okay, so this guy was born in the United States, so we're getting the picture now. All right, but he came here when he was 5. His auntie was actually married to a Mexican man, so that's how he...
Todo mundo.
¿Cómo se llama mi reina?
Yo me llamo María Luisa.
Okay, ¿cuántos años tu familia vivir aquí?
Yo tengo 52.
52, como la 30, baby. She says she's 52. It's like, no, but like really, she got the 30 looking going on.
Bueno, yo quiero conozco la cultura de los afro-mexicanos.
¿Bumbia?
Mis abuelos que vinían, que los traían, que traían a los afroamericanos, los traían donde venían antes, que los traían así como amarrados, como esclavos. Mis abuelos llegaron allá a Collante, y de ahí vengo yo, la dependencia de ahí es mía,
okay,
de los meros afroamericanos. Porque mi abuela era india, y ya mi abuelo era afro.
De América.
De Collante. Llegaron ellos a Collante. Ajá, llegó ahí los bajaron porque ellos trabajaban en esos barcos así.
Pero ¿dónde él llegó?
Los traían donde traían como trabajadores, los traían a ellos, pues como antes que los traían así.
África.
Ajá.
Okay, so puro de África. Descendientes.
Descendiente africano.
Okay. ¿Cuántos años tu familia vive aquí? How long your family been here?
Mi grandfather, maybe 100 years.
Wow.
Yeah, maybe. My history is long. They come in the one boat. My grandfather said they come in one boat. It's the many, many people here, the boat.
In tu family, ¿quién es afro?
Mi papá.
Tu papá.
Mi papá es afrodescendiente. Se dice que nuestra raíz es de Senegal.
Sí.
Gran parte de Senegal.
Okay, ¿y cómo tu vida aquí?
Feliz. Feliz.
Porque hay mucho surf.
Sí, tenemos buena ola.
Y some more dope murals of black women around here.
Ah, yeah, nice to meet you. Okay, come back.
Ah, that's his father, the one we just saw, the surf dude. Okay.
Maestro, él es maestro.
Oh, sí, buena gente.
Cuando tú quieras, ven con nosotros, güey.
Okay, thank you.